Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to make my tipletop flower. It is a daisy inspired flower. You're going to need a fluffy center style one. You can watch my tutorial listed below. And then you're going to need my template 12. You're also going to need a 4.5 inch base, a 4.5 inch thicker cardstock for the backing. This is with the hang tab. And then the petal sizes, you're going to need 12 cuts each of petal number 1, 2, and 3. 1 is 2 inch tall, 2 is 2.5 inch tall, 3 is 3 inch tall. And then you're also going to need 12 cuts of petal 5, 6, and 7, which is 4 inch tall, 4.5 inch tall, and 5 inch tall. For the base, you're going to need a 12-sided base or a circle, which is 4.5 inches wide. So let's get started. With the three smaller sizes, I'm going to roll them together. So I just grabbed a small stack and then I rolled it using a mini glue stick. And then you're gonna do this for the three smallest sizes. Also, if you haven't noticed, I've already cut slits in mine. This just makes it easier for me so I don't have to cut them later when I assemble. So once again, all I'm doing is grabbing half of the stack and then rolling it over so it looks like this. And this, you will do this for the three smallest sizes. I'm setting them aside. Now for the three larger sizes, I'm going to grab in a set of 4 or 5. I'm gonna push it together and basically fold it in half. Once again, I just grab a small stack and I'm folding it in half. You're going to repeat this step for the three larger petals. And then do your best to make it evenly folded. After you fold it, I like to push them out to be a little flattened. Now that all of the petals are folded in half and curled, I'm going to start gluing the overlap. You just want to overlap it just slightly. because you don't want it to stand up too much. You just want it to stand up a little bit, but you want it to lay a little bit more flat. So here's the largest petal for the first layer. It's all glued together ready. Now I'm just gonna do the same thing for the next petal layer and for all of the other petals. Now for these rolled petals, just once again rolling them to make it bend in more. And once again, you're gonna glue the slits with a very small overlap. of the smaller ones, you want to like overlap maybe halfway across, since they're smaller, so you want them to have more surface area to glue to hold on to each other. So now that all the petals are ready to assemble, I'm gonna start with the largest size first. Glue the back left side, and we're gonna place it into the base. And then for the rest of this layer, I'm gonna glue all the way across and glue around until I get to the last petal. Now for the last petal, I like to tuck it in just slightly. And then glue the first petal down. Now I'm gonna do the same thing for the second layer. When you start the second layer, make sure you put the first petal in between two petals of the previous layer, and then repeat this all the way around. And then for the third layer, you would do the same thing. Once again, for the last layer, I'm gonna tuck it under the first, or the last petal, sorry. I'm gonna tuck it, the last petal under the first petal, and then I'm gonna glue the first petal of the layer down. Once again, I'm placing the first petal in between two petals of the previous layer, and I'm gonna do this all the way around again. So now that I have the first three petals glued down, I like to add the backing because it makes it easier for me. But you can always add the backing later. So I just realized I put glue on the wrong side of the backing. The hang tab should be on the inside, but okay, it's not a big deal. I'm just going to add it anyways. Now that the backing is on, I will continue making the flower. And starting with the first petal, I'm going to put it in between two petals of the previous layer. And you're just going to repeat this step all the way around until you're done with all three of the smaller layers. So now that the last layer is glued in, I'm just going my finger and curling the inner petals a little bit more. And now I'm gonna glue on the base, or not the base, the center. It's just my fluffy center style one. I like to add glue on the whole bottom and then I let it cool a bit more before I put it on. Now I'm just gonna tuck it in the center and then lightly hold it in place for a couple seconds. And there you have it. My template flower is completed. Thank you so much for watching.